Well, my dear friends, it's time to visit the graves of some absolute movie legends who chose to end their years in Switzerland. I'm going to embark on a quest to find those graves. One of them proved quite difficult to find, and it even says that in the internet. But brave Odette and myself took up the challenge, and we would like you to join us on our journey to find these graves, and a few more interesting things included, I can guarantee that. So any of you who cannot travel, for whatever reason, have fun with this armchair journey. I'm going to show you the route. We're going to be traveling from Zurich to Seligny in the French part of Switzerland. So from the German part of Switzerland to the French part of Switzerland, we will start off on our journey and let us have a look where it will take us. So we will be starting off our journey in Zurich and traveling down, mostly on the Autobahn, to Bern, then to Fribourg, and then on to Lausanne, and we're going to, let me just see if I can zoom in exactly where we're going to be, is down here in the tiny and beautiful town of Seligny. And I have a surprise. Not only after finding the graveyard, I have another surprise, but you'll just have to see what that is. After we find Richard Burton's grave, we will then be off to Audrey Hepburn's. Stay tuned, my dear friends, stay tuned. We stopped at this charming little town on the way down for a spot of lunch, parked right in front of a cafe bakery, and it turned out to be a good choice because the food was excellent. Topped off by a strawberry and cream tart, which I enjoyed very much. Yum, yum. And then it was onwards to our first destination, the town of Seligny. So here we are entering the town of Seligny. We didn't really focus on that town because we were sticking to a time schedule and we wanted to find Mr. Burton's grave before heading off to Audrey Hepburn's grave. This was approximately a 300 kilometer trip, and so we had to really make our way to our hotel destination, which we had pre-booked. So let us go and find his elusive grave, my dear friends. So we walked up this track because we looked on the map and it said that the town cemetery was up here. We ended up being blocked by this huge tractor, which we had to walk around, and a young gardener was doing his work up there. It turned out that it was very good that he was working out there because he helped us to find Mr. Burton's grave. So apparently, Richard Burton got fed up with Hollywood and all the hangers-on and sycophants, and he just wanted somewhere that reminded him of Wales and possibly a tax haven as well. That always helps. And so he moved to the tiny town of Seligny, which was even smaller back then than it is now. And it's tiny. And so he bought an abandoned, well, a run-down farm chalet and renovated it himself. Apparently he never learned the language, and the whole time he was there, he moved there in the 1950s, never learned the language, and he would drive around this 1950s Cadillac drunk. It took a while for the locals to get used to him, as you can imagine. Apparently, in his heyday, he could drink 3 bottles of vodka and smoke 100 cigarettes a day. Hooly dooly. That's a lot. Yeah, so, and he loved it there. It's obvious. He stayed there until his death in 1984. Something I hadn't actually realized, that his very last role was the movie 1984, the adaptation of George Orwell's novel. As the story goes, John Hurt, his fellow star actor, came over to visit Richard and his wife at the time at their house here in Seligny. And he had been off the drink for a while, Richard, and he decided to get back on it again that night with John Hurt. And they went to the local restaurant and drank red wine. And sometime during that evening, during the night when he was asleep, he suffered a terrible stroke and died. Very sad. Only really young, actually. You never know when you're going to go. Anyway, this is the cemetery. And it's the only cemetery that's really listed in Google as belonging to the town of Seligny. So we headed back. We looked around the graveyard, Odette and myself, three times. Looked at each grave and thought, well, either they've moved the grave or it's not here. So we went and tracked down that young gardener. And he was very obliging. With my Google Translate and a bit of sign language, he pointed us in the right direction. By the way, took a recorder along to try and capture any EVPs, also at Audrey Hepburn's grave, but there was too much ambient noise, the wind factor and the birds, etc. I listened back, but usually EVPs are very faint and I couldn't hear anything. So the young gardener hadn't even heard of Richard Burton, but he did know of an old cemetery where nobody was allowed to be buried anymore. And that was the thing Richard Burton had stated before he died. He would love to be buried in that cemetery. And so the town authorities made a special exception for him, and he was laid to rest in this beautiful, idyllic little spot. Wait till you see it. Odette declared that she wanted her ashes to be strewn here, and I also, although if we didn't go together, it's a long distance for the bereaved to visit their loved one. But as she quite rightly says, she's not there anyway. Her spirit is free, but she just liked the idea of her ashes being left here. And I must say, I do as well. We have vowed that next time we come back here, that we shall have a bottle of wine and picnic with us, and we shall sit down and enjoy this absolutely fabulous spot. And we both said it's the best cemetery we've ever visited. I hope you're not underwhelmed, my dear friends. We loved it. You had to be there. I guess you had to feel it. The energy was fantastically serene, really wonderful, right next to a babbling brook. Birds were going wild with spring energy. It was fantastic. By the way, I didn't speed up the journey to the cemetery. I assumed that you wouldn't mind joining us for the leisurely stroll. And it was such a pleasant day. We were blessed with the weather. So lucky. Fantastic. You know, the weather's glorious here in Switzerland. I hope you enjoyed it. Unsightly bin out the front, but forget about that. Ignore that. Don't look at it. Here we go through the gates into this beautiful, and no one around. No one around. No one comes here. But they keep it beautifully. They keep it well manicured. And here we have Richard's grave. Here it is. Mr. Burton lies here. And you can see there's not many tourists get down this way. It's very simple. Very simple. Very beautiful. And he's overlooking the stream there. It's exactly where he wanted to be. And his wishes were fulfilled. Absolutely gorgeous here. Yeah, so this is the really old part, the old cemetery. No one is allowed to be buried there anymore. I don't think they would allow a Oddie Beau to be buried here, or an Odette Beau, so we just have to sneakily sprinkle each other's ashes. Well, somebody else will have to sprinkle our ashes here. Yeah, well, they seem more modern. These might be established families in the town. Beautiful, though. And this is right at the end of the cemetery. This must be the oldest part. And they extended onwards down in a long, narrow design. But some of the graves are gone. There's not much left of them at all. Probably some of them have disappeared under the ground. You can barely make out the writing on them. This would have all been graves here. They just disappeared. It's so quiet. It's so beautiful. Yeah, so apparently John Hurt and Richard Burton were enjoying a 400-pound bottle, not in weight, 400 English pounds worth of red wine. And apparently the bottle was only half finished when they retired for the evening. But they probably had a couple of bottles before that, I would imagine. But yeah, so there was half a bottle of wine left, and a reporter at the time of the funeral of Richard Burton found his way to this restaurant that was Richard's local restaurant where he could stumble home afterwards, within walking distance of his home. And the restaurant owner said, well, look, have a glass of wine. Richard would have wanted that. Could you imagine how much that bottle of wine would be worth now? £400. I mean, that was in 1984. 400 quid for a bottle of wine? That's expensive. Must have had a lot of dosh. Hooly dooly. It's all that tax haven money that... Tax exemption. I would be tax... Well, they don't have that really anymore in Switzerland. That's sort of a bygone era, isn't it? Still, it's not bad. What the Swiss government does is they do deals with very rich people. They give them really very good tax rates compared to normal people. Not fair, but that's the way it works. So this is behind Richard's grave. These are obviously things that people have left, and the grave workers have just stuffed them behind there, huddled all together. Not very nice. Put them at the front. People left them there for a reason. So there they are. I thought I'd show the world the things that people have left. So that's it for Richard's grave. We found it. The quest was completed. Next, on to Audrey Hepburn's grave. But before we head there, let's go and try and find Richard's house. That's also quite elusive. When he bought the house here in the 1950s, there would have been absolutely nothing around him. There's not much there now, but the road is somewhat busier and there is nowhere to park. And then you have to find the place. But Oddie recognized the gateway from photos. So this is when he first bought the house. It had this metal fencing and he put the sign on. Lepai de Gaulle, which means Wales, basically. That was his little bit of Wales. And I do remember in an interview, he said that Switzerland reminded him of the landscape of Wales. So that was his little bit of home. And the owners later, the next owners, had a sign made with the same writing to honor his memory. I'm surmising, unless Richard himself had a different sign made at a later date, that's possible as well. Somebody may be able to provide that information. So let's have a quick look at what Richard's house looks like now. I just parked in front of the neighbor's driveway. I blocked their driveway just to be as quick as possible. So here we go. This is the landscape right near Richard's house. This is the road, a lot busier than it would have been in the 1950s, even in the 1980s. This area is very expensive to live in. I don't know. He probably got a bargain price back then. But it's really for the rich people. So you can imagine how much this house and land is worth now. So there you go, Le Pays de Gare. Richard's Little Wales, right there in Switzerland, in the canton of Geneva. Beautiful. It's right behind that is the lake. So I would say his property dipped down with a big view of the lake. Wonderful. It's what you want. You have privacy. You don't want Hollywood on your back door. You want tax exemption. That's all these things that you really need. And when you've got lots of money, you can get that. Money buys you freedom. Money buys you space. Mostly, anyway. Anyway, onwards now to Audrey Hepburn's grave. Join me, my friends. Okay, so now we are in Saligny, and we want to go to find Audrey Hepburn's grave. And it's not that far. So there we are at Saligny, and now we wish to go to Tollenchenar. Tollenchenar, probably pronounced that wrong. There we are. It's a bit of a drive, but they weren't that far. You see, they've got the beautiful lake nearby, and it's also a gorgeous town. We'll have a quick look at it. Join me, my friends. So this is the village of Tollenchere, where Audrey Hepburn moved to in 1966. She'd had enough of Hollywood, and she wanted to get her two sons away from the glare of the Hollywood paparazzi. So they've moved to this tiny little town, and she remained there for the rest of her life. She died from cancer in 1993, and was interred in the local graveyard, which we are about to search for. So this is a sign at the local bus stop. Place Audrey Hepburn. So they're very proud of their connection to Audrey Hepburn. I guess it's brought a bit of money to the town with the tourist trail heading there. the town where Richard Burton is interred hasn't made such a big deal of it, not really advertising it that much, as far as I can see. But here they're quite proud of that. They even have a bronze bust of her right near the town hall. Let's have a quick look at it. This is the town, and there is the little square with the bronze bust of Audrey. Odette, come and have a look. I just pointed it out to Odette. I don't know why, because neither of us can speak French. Oh dear. And these, my dear, are the Audrey Hepburn Memorial Toilets. Public and free of charge in Zurich. They cost between $1 and $2 to use. This one's totally free of charge. And Oddie was in well need of a pee, except for that candle-looking thing, that candle-looking knob and the very greasy, dirty-looking string, so I pulled it right near the top. In these times, you can't be too careful. So this is outside the top. I'm only kidding though, it's not really the Audrey Hepburn Memorial Toilet. Just me having a bit of a joke. Audrey Hepburn Square. There we go. Have a look. And now, on to the cemetery. With the help of a very kind local, she guided us in the right direction, and we soon found our way to the front gates. Come on, join us and head through while we go and look for Audrey's grave. Couldn't get the damn thing open. Get over there. Give it a bit of a brute force. There you go. Trying to keep me out. No deal.
Bonjour.
So, spirits, I come in peace. Please welcome me as your guest, and I shall not bide long. Let me have a quick look. Will we find it quickly, or will it take an eternity like Richard Burton's grave? They're doing some work here today. Spoke to the chap afterwards. He spoke really good English. He's such a nice bloke. He directed us to another cool town, which you will see during this presentation. And there she is. There's Audrey. Her grave is really looked after, as you can see, a lot more than Richard's. And people have got their little photos of her there. Isn't that sweet? Her own little garden here. Similar to the one she enjoyed at home. Look, there's a sweet little butterfly. Maybe it's Audrey, the spirit of Audrey come to say hello to Oddie and Odette. Hello, Audrey. Fly away, my dear. Enjoy your life, for the short life a butterfly has, and I'm talking rubbish. So, my dear friends, that was Audrey Hepburn's grave. Before we continue our journey to travel to where Charlie Chaplin's grave is, stick around, we'll check out the town of Tollenchairs, quite sweet, and we meet an adorable daft kitty right in the middle of town. You'll love him. So sorry, guys, I just found this when we got back. Apparently there's an Audrey Hepburn Museum, and I didn't even know. We would have went to it most definitely. We've already been to the cemetery, as we see there. And we didn't know there's been a little exhibit on Audrey's life. And apparently that is the little Vespa scooter on which Gregory Peck and her tooled around Rome. Oh my goodness. A small museum in Morgue. I think it's Morgue. I think that's how they pronounce it. Probably wrong. But that would have been nice to go and visit. Next time, most definitely. And perhaps if you are planning a visit to Switzerland, don't forget there is a museum, not just the graveyard. Oh my goodness, I didn't know. Oh well. Sorry about that. Look at this sweet little cinema. I've always wanted my own cinema, a mini one like that, where I can just bore people with reruns of my presentations. The Oddie Beau Regs. I'd love it to go bankrupt within a year. Please give me one as a present, God. And that I don't have to pay tax on it like the film stars, please. So this is the town of Tollenchairs, or Tollenchairs. I've pronounced it a few different ways, I think, throughout this presentation. But it's a gorgeous medieval town, as you can see. Really nice. It looks out of the Middle Ages, some parts. This is actually a school, but it used to be a castle. Probably they poured boiling oil and boiling fat on people and fired arrows at them. And now it's a school. And of course these horrible cranes are everywhere nowadays. It's just been a building boom going on. It's horrible. I don't know, they're trying to cram people into rabbit hutches. Knock down the old houses and put up these blocks. And where the front and back garden was, it's just right onto the curb they've built these blocks of flats. You can shake hands with your neighbour from the balcony. It's really horrible. Better to live out in the Nevada desert on your own ranch. Most definitely. Ah, dear. I'm whinging. So look at this cat. He's daft as a brush. I love him. He's showing off. He wants to greet us. You know, he's ready to do a bit of a roll. And look, and there he goes. Oh. Not to be put off. He said that didn't happen. You didn't see that. He didn't see that. Isn't he cute? Isn't he sweet? Oh, my goodness. I hope nobody gives him a boot. I'm always worried about cats that are overly friendly. There's Oddie. That someone is, you know, someone not so nice. I hope this cat is very intelligent and that pratfall was unintended. So this was our hotel suite. The hotel is very modern, smells great, everything is ultra clean, great wet cell. I don't like those sinks though. It just looks like it's half filled with milk. You can't really scoop your hands in. Oh, I'm old fashioned. But I really couldn't complain. The place was soundproofed with blackout curtains. I'll tell you the name of the hotel soon. I would recommend paying a few extra bucks and getting the grass side instead of the street side. It's well worth it. You know, at least you can sit out there with a balcony. Some of the rooms don't have a balcony. It's well worth paying a few extra bucks. But I can really recommend. The staff were fantastic. And the breakfast was great. All fresh ingredients. Really good. So this is the town right next to the hotel. This is where we stayed in the evening. So after we checked into the hotel, we had a wander around the town. And it's full of different nationalities. It's an amazing place. That's where we ate. It's an incredible place. And you can really, there's no cars allowed, so you can wander around. I love towns where there's no cars allowed. Absolutely fantastic. You can really relax. You haven't got, as I said before in other videos, you haven't got a white van up your ass. It's good. I guess they have deliveries maybe during the early in the morning, but here in the afternoon, didn't see any cars. Fantastic. That's Pestalozzi. Look him up. He was an educational reformer. He believed in the right to education for everyone, poor people included. He was really, really setting a precedent back then. It's lucky they didn't chop his head off. Because the elite don't want the masses educated, do they? Less said the better. YouTube might demonetize me. Wonderful town. I can recommend it. I will put the name up so you can see where it is. You can Google it. Well worth the visit. And look, I saw this old lady. And I asked her if I could photograph her. I would have preferred to film her, but she couldn't understand English and I don't speak French. But she got the gist when I did the camera, you know, showing in the camera. What she was doing was, she was looking at these three plants of hers and she was looking from one to the other and then going back and doing the same thing. I think really she wanted to be a part of the crowds beneath. I think she was feeling a bit lonely. And that was her way, you know, of pretending to look at the flowers, but really be amongst the people at the same time, not being with them, but so sweet. Yeah, we waved a goodbye and she had a big beaming smile when we went, that somebody had noticed her. God bless her. So this is where we ate, at this restaurant here. Outside it was very warm, but an incredibly strong wind as well. Had to weigh down things on the table. It was blowing a real gust at the end. So I had char-grilled cheeseburger and chips, and Odette had roast beef, cold roast beef. It was absolutely really, really, really good. Look at this barbershop. Do you think Oddie Beau would suit one of these hairstyles? My goodness. Ah, very chic. What do you think? And so it was nearly time to go, and the hotel staff bade me farewell.
Thank you for staying with us, Oddie Beau.
Perfect, and it was a lovely stay. Thank you for the warm hospitality. And it was a fantastic room. I recommend that you stay here.
Great staff, great hotel. Here's the name. Highly recommend it. If you're in the area, pop in. You will enjoy it. You won't regret it. It's very reasonably priced as well. My dear friends, in part two, we visit the Charlie Chaplin Museum, the house he lived in, and his grave. Stay tuned for that. This is a fantastic museum. Wait till you see it. Hope you've enjoyed the presentation. Thumbs up if you liked it. Leave a comment. Always love your feedback. Odette sends her love and regards. Take care. Bye-bye, my friends.